I was an El Molino. A Soto Soto just talking women and vino. The contract like 91 Dan Marino. I swear this guy Michael Rapino's boosting my ego.
We're in the brand new 2019 GT63S 4-door. It's a pretty long ass name. This is a pre-production car, so it doesn't even have a VIN or anything. It's here at Mercedes-Benz in Chicago for a week from the factory. And yeah, as exclusive as you can possibly get. There's never been a GT 4-door ever before, so brand new model. And yeah, we're just driving around the block into the dealership. That's all we're allowed to do with it. We have orders from the factory that we cannot drive it anywhere because it literally doesn't even have a VIN number or anything. It's probably not even legal to drive on the streets. So we definitely don't want to get it pulled over or anything. But yeah, it has everything fully spec'd, obviously, since it is a factory car. I don't know why it's beeping at us. It's probably mad at us already.
I think it's out of gas.
But yeah, full carbon pack, yellow seat belts. Exterior is, what's the exterior? Matte black, right?
Yeah. I think it's matte, selenite, magnum, gray.
Matte black exterior. We got our new car manager, he's from the south somewhere with that accent. Yeah, pretty, like I said, pretty exclusive. You don't get to do this a lot, so. This is awesome. We're gonna make the best out of it, and hopefully you'll stop beeping at me. But I think, yeah, it's literally out of gas. Probably has nothing in it, which the factory might have done on purpose so we don't drive it. So, I mean, that was just me literally grazing the throttle. Like, I didn't even try. I think this is the fastest four-door production car in the world, I believe.
Good night, Panamera.
yeah, good Panamera kill for sure. There's no reason to get a Panamera. I mean, once you look at this, it's such a like a hot rod. It has such an edge over the Panamera. Panamera, it looks like a grandpa car compared to this. Yeah. I'll do a little squirt here before we pull it into the dealership. Again, that's just me playing around. Can imagine if I actually
squirt
seriously wanted to do anything. All right, without further ado, here it is. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the, get ready for it because it has a extremely long name, 2019 GT63S 4-door. So it is the 4-door version of Mercedes GT sports car, which both comes in a coupe and a Roadster version. And now what they did, as you can see here, they added two more doors to the back of it. And if you look at it, it looks amazing. It looks as if it's something, I don't know, from outer space. So retains a lot of obviously the design from the GT. Obviously it's still the same car, except two more doors. And then if we open these doors in the back, you can see it's a little bit dark, but hopefully you can see. You got a 2+2 setup. The center right here, you have kind of like cup holders, etc. These two seats here, so this one and that one right here, they're kind of bucket setups, which are really nice. You got the yellow seat belts. But yeah, I'm going to show you more of the interior in just a little bit. So just kind of a background on this car. This is actually a car from the factory, from MB USA, Mercedes-Benz USA. It's a pre-production vehicle. Meaning, and the reason this is so exclusive, this vehicle doesn't even have a VIN number, okay? So it does not have a VIN number. It is not for sale. It cannot be sold. And correct me if I'm wrong, you can probably correct me in the comments here. I believe these cars with the manufacturer, after it's done here with us and whatever else it's gonna do, I think it's going to go to COTA, Circuit of the Americas, after Thanksgiving. they're gonna do like a racetrack event for, it's kind of training for all the employees at all the dealerships throughout the United States, where they're going to be able to take this thing out on the racetrack and learn about it more and drive it on the racetrack, etc. And I think after that, I think it either gets, I believe they get crushed. So I don't know if they get crushed here, if they get sent back to Stuttgart and they crush them there, but obviously it doesn't have a VIN number, so it cannot be sold. It's just amazing. This is, I mean, it's an entirely brand new model. There's never been a GT four-door, obviously, in the past. The GT in itself as a model is pretty new to Mercedes. I think it's been out for a couple years now, if that. I'll get to the spec of this. So the spec, as you can see, it has a matte black paint, matte or satin finish paint. This paint is part of Mercedes's Designio line, okay? They have their line of matte finish paint straight from the factory. Obviously, it's not a wrap. This car is painted like this from the factory. So they're the Designio matte colors, and they designate those, they call them Magno, okay? So they call them Designio, wow, can barely talk tonight. They call them Designio, Magno, and then whatever the color is. I believe this one is called Magno Graphite. Correct me if I'm wrong. Actually, I don't even know anything, so this is all just gibberish. So please correct me in the comments. But yeah, I believe this is called Designio Magno Graphite or something like that. So as you can see, satin finished color. You can kind of see the fingerprints here. Extremely smooth, and it looks amazing. I cannot describe it all. I hope this video does at least some justice to show you how amazing the spec is in this satin finish color. So satin finish color, you could see it has the gloss black accents. I believe that's part of the AMG night package, they call it, where they just, what they basically do is they black out a bunch of stuff. And this is blacked out and gloss finish. So it's not a matte finish, it's gloss. As you can see here by the tips, this is all gloss. You can get a good shot of the rear diffuser here. Extremely aggressive. That's all gloss. The tips, I believe, let's see, the tips are black as well. So I believe these can be ordered in chrome. And then I believe when you get the night package, these come in the same gloss black finish. So this is, it's smooth, so that's the gloss finish. Extremely nice, just paired with the darker Magno color here. It just really sets it off extremely nicely. Just great contrast. So you get it on, I'll just start from the back here. The night package, you get it from the back. I hope this is not going to turn into like a Doug DeMuro painful 30 minutes.
Clickbait!
And then gloss black front diffuser, which is extremely aggressive. I mean, look at the opening. So this is all gloss black here. This is gloss black. This is gloss black. And then speaking of the front, so this is the front. It's amazing. Just utterly insane. You have the two here, what do you call them, kind of not hood scoops, but they just bulge out the hood. I think the C63, like the first generation of the C63, was the first one that kind of had that. It's, you can see it from inside from the car. It just it's amazing. It just gives you that extremely muscular look. And then what I love about the front end design, obviously the grille. So all new, I believe all the proper AMGs, so not the 43s, the 53s, the proper 63 AMGs will have this grille. It's called the Pan America grille, okay? And I believe the GT was the first model that kind of incorporated that with the slats here. But if you look at the design, obviously from it just obviously being just amazing, and I'm actually trying to not curse here as I try to describe this car. So I'm not gonna use any F words or anything. Maybe I'll say, I don't know, fudge. But if you look at it, it's like angled, it's angled in. So it kind of makes it look, if I focus here, kind of like, I don't know, like a sharp. So it's just amazing. It's so striking the way they designed that, where it angles in. Unlike anything I've really seen in the past recent years from any manufacturer. So, I mean, they just nailed it. Anyways, let me unlock it here. This will be a cool shot of me unlocking it. Boom. I think it's already unlocked. Yep, there we go. Lights come on. You can see the machine here. It was kind of dead from people playing around with it all day. So we did charge it a little bit, the battery. Yeah, if you look at the lights, just again, really aggressive. Just imagine this tailgating year coming up from the back. It just looks like the you know, what comes to mind is always shark. Looks just like a really aggressive shark, which obviously if you see that, you run. You run as fast as you can. The back too, the lights are just so thin, which is extremely awesome design. Again, they kind of incorporate the lights from the GT Roadster and Coupe, but they're just so thin. It's amazing, whereas, you know, you're usually used to, you know, larger, bulkier lights from Mercedes. And then if you look at it straight from the back here, this is a nice shot, actually. Yeah, that just looks menacing. I think that should conclude the exterior. So let me start the interior here. So if you go inside again, so interior on this one is just, it's black, black on black. You got the carbon fiber trim, which if you look at it, it's the matte carbon fiber trim. So there's no gloss finish to it. It's matte, it's carbon fiber, but it's matte. And then so black leather, and then you have in the center here, kind of hard seats, a little bit dark, but you have the black Alcantara. So black Alcantara inserts with the yellow stitching, which again, this just steps it up from design-wise from Mercedes and AMG. I believe this is one of the first cars where you can get contrast stitching like this, which just really takes it to, in my opinion, to another level. I mean, if you just look at the seat and the yellow stitching, I mean, it's just purely amazing. And this is just a full bucket seat here. You know, really supportive. I mean, really keeps you in place. Amazing. Got the steering wheel here, which is just amazing. This is the latest generation steering wheel. I think the S-Class was the first one to kind of get this with the much larger updated controls here on the steering wheel. Alcantara steering wheel, which is just amazing. I mean, any car I've owned in the past obviously had a leather steering wheel, but whenever you drive a car with Alcantara, it's just different. Just feels so much nicer, cooler. Again, it's just different from what you're used to. It has the awesome yellow ring here to kind of tell you where the center is when you're, I guess, when you're on the track. They took inspiration from the AMG hypercar Project One, or I believe they call it just One now or something, I don't know. These things right here. This thing, and then these buttons here. I'm gonna turn the car on in a second. They'll light up. So, which again, just changes the game, because that's never, that was never available before in the interior of an AMG. So if you look at here, let me turn it on some more. There we go. So you can see, so this is my driving mode. So C for comfort. Let me put the key here. And then, so if I switch it, that's sport, and you can see the display kind of changed. So we got comfort, sport, sport plus, and race. And then it's really awesome. So this, it has like a small LED display right here. Again, changes the game. This is straight out from the AMG hypercar. It's gonna be coming out, I think, in a year and a half or 2 years from now. That's basically, if you guys read about it, Formula One car for the road. So you got the snow symbol and everything here, comfort, sport, sport plus, race. Okay, and then here you have, so I guess this is your traction control. Again, really cool steering wheel. Got the huge aluminum paddles, which just give you the most amazing kind of mechanical feel here. You got the, you know, this is not that new anymore, but the lighting all around the interior, so it kind of looks like a strip club, no? And it goes around in the back as well. So you have the blue. So I believe you have like 60 plus colors to choose from. I think it's like 64 or 68, which you're able to change in the settings here somewhere. So yeah, these are firsts. And then kind of similar, the center stack here, if we go here, boom, you got the same thing. You got where the buttons here are for all your different settings. They're also lit up in LED, which again just changes the gain, because before this would just be, you know, a button with the symbol. It wouldn't be lit up by LEDs. So that's really futuristic, really amazing, just, you know, really cool touch. So let's see here. So we got the race. I guess you could change modes here too. Yeah. So I can toggle through my different modes here as well. Transmission. Okay. So I can put a manual or drive. So manual if I want to switch gears myself. Drive of the car. If you want automatic shifts. This is your suspension. So sport, sport plus, comfort, suspension. Traction control. Off or on. Volume. Did you do up or down? Again, this is either traction or stability control. I think this is stability. This is the wing. This is amazing. As you see, I just got excited there. So put this down. Oh, yeah, you can hear it. You can probably, you won't see it, but I just put the wing down. And then it shows you. The wing is down. Oh, yes. Extremely important. Actually, I'm sorry. The most important button in the car. The only button you really need to know about. Just dragging on here. Extremely painful. I bet you 90% of the people who started watching this already left, which they should. Exhaust button. So you push this and boom, you get the louder exhaust. Oh, I'm sorry. Actually, we have more than just loud and not loud. So if I push this, I got powerful, balanced. Oh, I guess balanced is the quiet exhaust. Or I don't even know if I put it, let's see if I maybe put it in comfort, what happens then? Yeah, powerful and balanced. I guess powerful is loud. That's what you're trying to say. Let's, you know what? Let's turn down Ariana Grande. I had enough of her. And let's try and start the vehicle. I'm gonna go ahead and start it for you. Hopefully I won't terrify if there's still anybody left. So, pretty okay. I'm gonna put it in, I don't know if you heard the flaps open, but they definitely did. It's definitely much louder. I'm in race, so probably flaps are open all the way. And then I'm gonna put this thing in, so you can hear the flaps closed right now, balanced, quiet. And then if I push it again, powerful, loud. I'm gonna give it a couple of revs. I'm not gonna do a lot because, again, I don't want to terrify anybody if there's anybody still left in the building. Oh, yeah, you can hear the pop, so I'm definitely not gonna do this a lot, because if there is anybody left in the store, they'll think that somebody is shooting, which it is Chicago, and don't want them to think that their lives are at risk when I'm just reviewing the GT four-door here. I'm just gonna give it a little bit, just one more. No pops. Yep, there we go, one more pop. So yeah, very loud. I'm gonna show you the back since we have it running. Amazing sound. I'm sure it sounds much better under load. I'm gonna turn it off so I don't suffocate myself. So yeah, that was the 2019 GT63S four-door. Jesus, longest name ever. Hope you liked it. Let me know what you guys think about these videos. Again, this is one of our kind of our first kind of lifestyle GIOLI videos where it's going to be on other things than the products that we offer, just to kind of show you lifestyle stuff like amazing and exclusive pre-production vehicles with no VIN number in the US. I don't know. Let me know if you like it. You can see the yellow seatbelt. Extremely cool. You can see the bucket seat behind me. Please subscribe, comment, like, share. Love it, hate it, always say that. Give us feedback. Visit our store. Buy some of our product, which could probably make me look much better right now after a 13, 14 hour workday. Again, this video has been sponsored by Mercedes-Benz of Chicago, my 9 to 5 currently. And yeah, I think I'm just rambling, and I probably need an outro. So thank you for watching. This is my outro with the GT63S AMG in the back. I hope you liked our first kind of lifestyle GIOLI video with the review of this thing. Again, like, comment, subscribe, share, all those things. Yeah, that's it. We'll see you on the next one. Look, fuck all that happy to be here shit that y'all want me on. I'm the big homie, they still be trying lil' bro me, dog. Like